My refrigerator stopped working, so I had to pull it out, which is a pain in the butt. But Jamie was nice enough to help me get it out of there, and all my stuff is out. As you can hear, I got it back working. It would work on 110, but not DC, so I knew it had to do something with either the plug or the wiring. So I looked through the wiring, the fuse, everything looked good. And I pulled this out. It's probably hard to see. And the prongs that are usually in here are now in the refrigerator. They're stuck in that hole. So I just cut the stupid plug off. Not a very good design if those metal prongs pop off. If I'd push it in far enough, it would come back on. But as soon as I let go of the plug, it would cut off. So not a good connection at all. Yeah, there are the prongs. They're stuck on the tabs. So this is my fix. Those are detachable prongs, so I can disconnect it if I need to. And I just pulled the wire from the back, negative to negative and positive to positive. And now it's working again. Ugh. But I guess it's a good thing that this happened anyways, because as you can see, the damage on the bottom of this cabinet, because this is just paneling and not meant to support this refrigerator. So I'm going to go and rebuild this cabinet and put a better support system underneath here. That way I don't have a problem. And I'm going to make the refrigerator fit better. It was always kind of lopsided in this cabinet. So, yeah, I need to fix that before I put the refrigerator back in. So I know it's going to be a pain in the butt, but I guess the refrigerator is going to stay right there until I can get it, this cabinet fixed. Well, it's been a few days, and it was a pain in the butt having the refrigerator in the middle of the floor, but I made it work. I was finally able to get the base of the cabinet replaced and also painted. Well, I've got the new base in for the refrigerator cabinet, and all I have to do is just seal the sides, and then I'm going to paint it. I have all the edges sealed and the inside of the cabinet painted. I've cut an access here. I'm going to put a door there, and that way I can get in to the back of the refrigerator without having to pull the refrigerator completely out. This way I can access the drain, the plug, the compressor, and stuff like that. This is the door that I purchased. It was $5 at the recycle center, and I bought a little vent to go on the front because I'm gonna vent this as well, because the fan and the compressor is in the back and it needs some ventilation, and I never had it ventilated, so I think it'll run better. So I've got to clean up my mess there, and then I'm going to put a second coat on this. I had thought to put the door sideways, but instead I'm going to put it long ways, because if I put it sideways, I'm going to have to cut into the beams, and I really don't want to do that. The door is small enough and it fits perfectly in between the beams. That way I don't mess with the structure. And I'm really pleased with that. I'm going to install this vent into the door right there. I'm going to drill two holes, larger holes. That way there's an in and out flow. And I think that will work really well. I went ahead and painted the areas that I'd missed, because this paint takes an hour to dry and 4 hours to cure. So in about 4 hours, I'm going to put a second coat on this. And it's thick enough. I don't think it'll require more than two coats. This is also a no VOC, which is volatile organic compounds, and those off gas, anytime I use those, they give me a headache. So this one does not give me a headache, and there's no smell, so this is working out really well. I think two coats will do it, and once I get the second coat on here and let that dry, then I will install that door. I made a template of the inner diameter of the inset for my door, so I can just trace this out onto, it's easier than putting the door up there because the smaller part that needs to inset is hard to get to. So I went ahead and did it on the cardboard first, and I drilled my hole so I know where the edge of this inner hole is. So I just have to match this template to the holes, and then I will trace a line there and I'll know where to cut. Now that I have my template traced to the wall of the RV, time to cut it out. Hard to see when you're short. Ladder. I have to install the tape around the edge, but I'm gonna dry fit it and see if it works. Yep, good to go. Awesome. Hello! Oh, wait, hold on. Okay, fits good. I've installed the polymer sealing tape all the way around the edge to prevent leaks. The door is installed. I've pre-drilled all the holes. Now I just have to put the stainless steel screws in. Where's my camera? Oh, yeah. All right, well, it is done. Oh, right out here. Okay. Just lock it up. I just want a functional door there, something water won't get in. It doesn't have to be perfect. It is an older door, but once I paint everything, I am gonna caulk around the edge just for extra precaution so water doesn't seep in. I still do have to install the vent here, but I had positioned it for it being this way, so now I've gotta reposition the vent right here. The cabinet wall is painted and finished. It's almost complete. I have the refrigerator in, the sideboard in. It's completely sealed around the edges with just foam that I've inserted in there. I just have to put the facing boards and the trim, I mean. And I've bought a drain pipe for the refrigerator. This is the drain hose that I had installed previously. There's a pan here that collects the water, but sometimes it would overflow, so I put a drain on it. So I just need to install a drain here or an outlet for it because I don't want to put it through the door. I have the hole drilled for the drain pipe. Just gonna install the PVC pipe. This one here is gonna go in there, and I have the inner fitting. I got a curved pipe for the hose to go in. And then on this side, it's just a small fitting. There's the curved pipe that this is gonna insert into and then come out this way. I have to trim this now, trim it down. I had to pull the pipe out a little bit to cut it down, but now I'm gonna push it back in, put the back fitting back on, and put the front fitting on. So I just have to put this cap on. I already have sealant on the inside. What's going on there? Tight. All right, good to go. I just have to trim the hose. Everything is complete. The drain hose is out. That's all sealed up. I have the vent in there for the refrigerator. The only thing I really had to do out here is replace this lock, because when I bought the door for $5, they didn't have the key, which, no problem. Those locks are a couple dollars. I can finally pull this old hose out. This didn't work really well anyways. This is, I had it strung through the wall like that, and it got a kink there. I don't think it was working properly, so I can go ahead and pull this old hose out. This is where I just ran it to where the electric is, or the shore power. Project done. The refrigerator in and secure. Oh, I forgot to show you, this is the pantry. I used to have bins in here and they just hooked to a board and they weren't very secure. Now I have shelves. So, this is working out much better. These are the bins that I used to use right here. And they were just hooked to a pegboard, but yeah, this is so much better. So all in all, I'm really pleased with the project. It was not the simplest project. And before I had done that, the refrigerator was just sitting in the cabinet and I kind of had it strapped in. Now it's completely secure. it's not going anywhere. Even when I used to open and shut the door, I used to have to wiggle the refrigerator to get the door open. Now that is not an issue whatsoever. I can open the door with ease. And also, it wasn't set in there very well because the door was starting to lift, so it was starting to mess up the refrigerator. I'm glad to have it set in and secure where the refrigerator door can now easily open. I did install still security straps for when I'm driving because I don't want the door to fly open. So yeah, I mean, the project was kind of tough, but and a long project. I think it took me probably about a week and a half to get it done, but I'm glad that it's done now. And now I can move on to the next project, which is going to be my exhaust leak. And I'm going to we're going to take the headers off and check that out. And there's a few other things that I want to get done, plus an oil change since I'm here. We're going to check the spark plugs and everything. There's a big project coming up, and that'll be in the next video. I want to thank y'all for hanging out with me and checking out this project. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Well, I'll see you in the next video, hopefully. Until then, stay safe and onward bound. Love you guys out there. Bye for now.